Neumann Space, an Australian space startup, is working on propulsion drives that use metal as the fuel. That may sound strange, but the concept is simple. Blast the metal with an electric current to generate a plasma, which in turn generates thrust. That's it in a nutshell. It has some advantages over other propulsion systems. We'll get into that later, but first more about the startup. The company is based in Kent Town in Australia, close to the Australian Space Agency, which I'm sure is helpful. From the website, we have this quote from Dr. Paddy Neumann. Space is unimaginably vast, but the useful parts of space are not. Since more missions are using this finite volume, more and better propulsion systems are needed to help keep Earth orbit open for all, unquote. The company was founded by Peter Schultz and Dr. Patrick Paddy Neumann, who is the chief scientist, and James Schultz is the director. Their team has many talented and high-skilled individuals with backgrounds in business, science, and engineering. Neumann Space has already launched its drive into space several times already, in 2023 on the Skycraft 1 mission, in 2025 for an in-orbit demonstration mission in partnership with the European Space Agency. This latest mission used the Neumann Drive in the CubeSat form factor to help test the design. Neumann Space are working on refining the drive for efficiency improvements for future missions. Okay, let's look at the technology. Neumann Drive, Solar Electric Ion Propulsion System. The company manufactures a range of drives to suit different satellite buses. For instance, CubeSat, SmallSat, and customer-specific drives. Neumann describes their drives as simple, solid-state, robust, and with flight heritage. They are easy to manufacture, which makes them well-suited for constellations and with the added advantage of coming fully fueled. Since the fuel is just metal, it's safe to handle the satellite with easy installation into the satellite bus. Minimal paperwork since there is no dangerous or toxic substances used. Any solid conductive metal or alloy works, so fuel is plentiful and cheap. Technology. The Neumann Drive uses the patented center-triggered pulsed cathodic arc thruster, or CTPCAT for short. This converts a solid conductive fuel rod into plasma to produce thrust. The drive can generate high specific impulse levels. The values vary depending on the metal used, but around 2000 seconds is possible for the CubeSat form factor and 2500 seconds for the SmallSat drive. Lighter propellants, such as magnesium, achieve 3000 seconds of specific impulse. Delta V depends on many factors, but a rough estimate would be between 0.5 2.5 kilometers per second. Okay, let's look at the physics to understand how the drive works in more detail. Solar panels generate electricity that is stored in a capacitor bank. When the arc is turned on, it immediately generates a pulse of electricity, hitting the fuel rod, which is converted into plasma. This plasma exits the spacecraft, generating thrust. The plasma stream is self-neutralizing, meaning it consists of positive and negative particles, which eventually combine so no charge buildup happens on the spacecraft. This is important because ion thrusters need to add neutralizers to inject electrons into the exhaust to neutralize positively charged ions. This adds cost, mass, and complexity. The Neumann drive uses high currents in a very short, sharp pulse, only 200 microseconds or millionths of a second. The exhaust velocities can reach tens of kilometers per second, which is why the fuel efficiency is so high. Unlike ion thrusters that use inert gases, such as xenon or krypton, no electrostatic grids, virtual cathodes, or other methods of extracting an ion beam are needed. Vacuum arc technology. The drive uses a vacuum arc or cathodic arc, which vaporizes the metal rod directly into plasma. The website shows a graphic of their arc triggering, then forming cathode spots, and finally hitting the metal propellant rod, which causes plasma to be generated. Power consumption can be easily controlled by the arc duty cycle, that is the on-off ratio of the arc. The pulsed arc operates at very high current densities of around 3000 amps. Okay, physics is one thing, what about engineering? Making this technology work in a tiny form factor such as a CubeSat requires serious engineering skills. Here, you can see the cube form factor of the Neumann drive. This CubeSat drive has been tested and verified in space multiple times. No pressurized tanks or any of the other paraphernalia you'd find on a chemical thruster. And, as mentioned previously, each unit ships with the fuel already. Pulses can be fired at the rate the power system can manage. For lower power situations, the pulses are fired less often. The drive produces less thrust, but still maintains high fuel efficiency, which is not the case with some other ion thrusters that struggle when limited power is available. The Neumann drive works better in power-constrained environments because, unlike conventional ion thrusters, there is no need to power propellant management and neutralizer equipment. Metal propellants. Why is Neumann Space using metal for fuel? Well, if you look at the periodic table, many more elements are suitable for a metal drive system than with Hall effect and ion thrusters. In fact, it's not only metals. Any element or alloy that conducts electricity works, with the exception of some metals that melt at low temperatures, such as lithium, tin, gallium, mercury, and a few others. Metals known to perform well in a pulsed arc system are aluminium, titanium, magnesium, copper, iron, and nickel. Fuel costs would be under $100 per kilo, and in some cases below $10 per kilo. This is because, unlike liquid propellant for chemical thrusters or ion thruster gases, which require exceptional purity, that's not the case with the metal drive. Most metals are inherently safe to handle and store, and can withstand the radiation environment in space without problems. Benefits of metal drive propulsion. Some additional benefits of a metal propulsion drive are: the fuel is solid and doesn't change phase into a liquid or gas. Metal is stable under most circumstances, non-toxic, and can be handled without taking precautions. Very high dense fuel, compared to chemical thrusters that use liquid or gas propellants. No need for pressurized tanks. Metal is available in industrial quantities, cheap and not subject to large price swings historically. Low pre-launch costs due to simple plug-and-play integration into a satellite bus. Low logistics and paperwork compliance, and low risk for rideshare missions. Metal propulsion drives can be mass-produced, come fully fueled, while still being able to be stored for long periods of time before flight. Pulsed operation enables their use in power-constrained environments with no loss of fuel efficiency. For extended missions, just make the fuel rod longer. It's that simple. Upcoming events. Neumann Space has a number of upcoming missions. Coming soon in the first quarter of 2026 is the CARB-SAR satellite. This mission will launch a synthetic aperture radar satellite capable of collecting imagery day and night in all weather conditions. The satellite uses Neumann's pulsed arc technology for propulsion and station keeping, this time on a larger satellite bus, which is key to validating its performance for non-CubeSat missions. On their website, the company mentions a second mission in 2026, which will involve a constellation of satellites. What do you think of Neumann Space and their metal drive propulsion system? Do you think using metal for propulsion will become more popular in the future? Leave your thoughts and opinions in the comments section below. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this space video, consider buying me a coffee to help fund more episodes like this. The link is in the description. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. The live stream is a great way for you to share your thoughts and opinions on the videos I posted this week, or on any space topic in general. I highlight the most thought-provoking comments on videos I've received, along with previews of upcoming content. If you've got the time, please tune in and say hi. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.